How should I back up a new machine? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is an interesting problem when you get a new machine. It's almost a chicken and egg situation. Here's the question I got. I'm supposed to receive a new laptop tomorrow and don't quite understand how to make your suggested system image backup before connecting to the internet without connecting to get the software. Can I download it to an external drive and then run software directly onto the new machine offline? Like I said, this is almost a chicken and egg situation. In order to back up the machine, you want to download the software, but that modifies the machine that you're trying to back up. There are a couple of approaches to this that range from pedantic to pragmatic. And as you can imagine, I tend to favor the pragmatic approach. The goal is what we would call a pristine backup. In other words, a backup with ideally no changes whatsoever made to that hard drive in that new machine. You get that new machine, you somehow manage to back up the hard drive without any changes whatsoever. That way you have an image literally of the factory condition of that hard drive. The problem, of course, is as soon as you turn the machine on, unless you do something else, the system starts making changes. It boots into Windows and starts the setup process and basically starts making changes to the very thing you didn't want to have changed. Like I said, there are approaches to this. We can get a pristine backup, but ultimately, I tend to favor the pragmatic approach. And that's actually pretty simple. One, turn on the machine, let it boot, complete the initial setup, including going online. As soon as that process completes, as soon as you have control, then download your backup software, install your backup software, and take a backup image of your machine. Nope, it's not pristine. Right? You've made changes to the machine. You've set up your account. You've installed the software. But from a very pragmatic perspective, honestly, that's good enough. Chances are you're not going to need this anyway. This is a safety net. But if you do, you've got a backup that is as close as is reasonably possible to the hard disk when it arrived. Now, another approach is what I call pragmatic but disconnected. The very first thing you do is disconnect your machine, your new machine, from the internet. By that, I mean unplug any network cable, or as you're going through setup, because you are going to turn the machine on and you are going to set it up, don't specify your Wi-Fi. Not yet. You can do that later. That way, your machine will actually get set up and start running, but it will not reach out to the internet and it will not install anything other than what was already on the machine. It won't take any updates. It won't install any third-party things. It's just what the machine was when it delivered, configured with your account and running. Now, on a second machine, maybe your old machine, there, download your backup software's installer. Copy that to a thumb drive or some other drive that allows you to then take it to your new machine, install your backup software, and then take an image backup. It is, in theory, a little bit closer to pristine. It is not pristine. You'll have set up an account, you'll have, you know, logged in and that kind of stuff, but it will not have taken any updates. Once that backup image is complete, yes, then you can plug it into the internet or configure your Wi-Fi and carry on. But this backup will be a little bit earlier in the process with slightly fewer changes resulting from having set up the machine. What if you really want the pedantic, not a single bit changed solution? Well, there are two approaches. One is, again, on your second machine, install the backup software this time, and then have that backup software create rescue or emergency media. That is media that you would boot from normally to rescue or in an emergency, would allow you to restore a backup. But most of these drives will also allow you to take a backup. So what you do is you take this newly created emergency disk. You go to your new machine and you very, very carefully configure it to boot from USB first. Now, I say very, very carefully because if there's going to be a mix-up here, this is where it's going to be. Most recent machines have made this process complicated, overly complicated, I would say, and it may end up booting onto the hard disk anyway. It may start setting up your machine anyway. After that, technically, it's too late. Changes have started to be made. But the idea here is that if you can boot from your external media first, if you can boot from this rescue drive first, then your backup software can create an image backup of the main drive in the machine without anything ever having changed on that drive. Then when that backup is finished, you can disconnect your rescue media and boot from your hard drive normally and continue setting up the machine. But that theoretically would get you a bit-for-bit identical copy of your hard disk as it arrived on your doorstep before you did a thing. Like I said, it's problematic in the sense that the boot from something other than the hard disk can be error prone, but that's what it would take. There's another solution that I consider to be pedantic overkill, and that is simply this. Remove the drive from your new machine. Connect it to your second machine that has your backup software already installed, and then take an image backup of it. You will not have booted from it. You will not have made any changes to it. It'll be an external drive as far as that other machine is concerned, and you could take an image backup. Like I said, that's overkill as far as I'm concerned, and of course it does require removing the drive from your new machine, and you may or may not be interested in actually trying to do that. But that's another approach that would get you the pedantic bit-for-bit image of your new drive. What do I recommend? I recommend you back up. Seriously, I recommend you back up as soon as you can, but I don't think you have to go overboard. I really do think, and the process that I take myself, you don't have to do all these extra steps. I simply, as soon as the machine is up and I've got an account configured, then I'll take an image backup as soon as I can. Pragmatically, that's good enough. Like I said earlier, chances are you'll never need it. There's a really good chance that your machine will just continue to run. You'll deal with things as they come. If you do end up restoring to backups, you'll want something a little bit more recent anyway. You'll never really need to restore the entire machine to this factory initial condition. But it's a safety net. If you have it, it's one more option when you're fighting problems down the road. It doesn't have to be pristine. It doesn't have to be this pedantic bit-for-bit initial copy. Soon enough is good enough. For comments, for updates, for links related to this and more, visit askleo.com/154141. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.